Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us and welcome to our webinar. My name is Andrew Townsend. I'm an e-learning evangelist here at eLearning Brothers. Today, we're going to be talking about the power of shared actions in Captivate. Yes, this webinar will be recorded. We'll get a copy of this webinar out to all registrants, and we'll also be posting it on our website in a few days. If you have questions during the webinar, we will be ready to answer your questions in that questions panel, and we'll try to bring up as many questions as we can to our presenter. Speaking of our presenter, today we have Leva with us today. She's a well-known Captivate consultant and trainer, and she's very passionate about learning. Would you like to say a few words by way of introduction, Leva?
Hello all, welcome. Soyez les bienvenus, hartelijk welkom. Welcome all of you. I'm Leva. I don't want to talk about myself, but I want to pay a short tribute to Stephen Hawking, a great and passionate learner, teacher, and sharer.
Okay. Thank you so much. It is, we're all saddened by the loss of Stephen Hawking. But let's continue learning and let's talk about shared actions. So without further ado, I'll go ahead and make you the presenter and allow you to share your screen.
Hello all. Today I will be talking about shared actions, and I created a very short presentation with Captivate, of course, that will be made available later on as an interactive movie from my blog, and I think Andrew will send out the link as well.
Yep, you'll get it in the email later today.
Not today. It's not ready. I have to convert it from a presenter directed presentation to a standalone presentation, Andrew.
Oh, okay, we'll get it to you as soon as it's done then.
Yeah, okay, and I have to do the voiceovers, of course. So I have five small topics here. This is a dashboard. It's created with a shared action, and you will be seeing how to create such a shared action for a dashboard. I will talk first about how do you use an existing shared action, because that's a very interesting workflow. Then we will create some small shared actions, but then I want first to know from Andrew what's the result of the poll about the versions. And then I will talk a little bit more about parameter types, about the use of shared actions as a template, which is something that very few users know about, and then in which circumstances I will never use shared actions but prefer advanced actions.
Excellent. So the responses as to the version of Captivate coming in, we have early results are coming in. 57% of our audience is on Captivate 2017, and there's let's see, here's those results, and 39% of them are on Captivate 9. 5% of our audience is on Captivate 8 or an older version, but we do have, you know, a vast majority that is on Captivate 2017 and Captivate 9.
Okay, that's a relief. Sorry for the people who are on a version before 9, because I will show a lot of multi-state objects in combination with shared actions, and you don't have them. They appeared with Captivate 9. So let's start. What do I have on this dashboard screen except the five chapter topics? I have two interactive toggle buttons. This one, I will close it very quickly, is showing some credentials about me. And this one is a table of content. I will go to full screen just a minute. Okay. Table of content, because I took out the small arrows on top and I created a table of content button. And I will show you a shared action how to do that. So let's start about using shared actions. I created a step-by-step plan. The first thing to do if you want to use a shared action in a new project is to get it into that project. And the easiest way to do so is to open the older project where you have already the shared actions as an external library and to drag the shared actions into your new project. The next step will be to trigger that action by an event, whether it's a slight event or it's an event triggered by an interactive object is not so important. Then you will see that when you import a shared action that has variables in the action, and those variables are no parameters, later on you will understand more clearly what I mean. In that case, those variables are created automatically. So that's a lot of saving time. The next step is you need to create items that you need for the action, of course, in the new project. If you don't have the items, you can't reference to them. You trigger it by an event. In this case, this example is for an on-enter slide event, and you choose the command execute shared action just below the command execute advanced actions. In this case, the button next to the shared action field itself is not a browse button like for advanced actions, but it's a button with a P in it, a P of parameters. You have to click that button and then you get the shared action parameters box, where you have to indicate based on the description of the shared action parameters and the description of the shared action itself, what you want to do with that shared action. One of the first advantages to me of a shared action over an advanced action is that you can have description of everything inside of the shared action. That's not possible with an advanced action, as you probably know. The next step is you can see, since a shared action is in the library, you have all the features of that library. So you have the usage button as well. When you click on that usage button, or you click on the number of times it has been used, the shared action, you will see the usage dialog box popping up, and you can check there if you have indeed the right instances of that shared action and attributed to the right events. So here you see an example where the same shared action has been attributed to 5 buttons. Like in the dashboard, there are 5 buttons. The next step, of course, is to test in all situations, because that's the most important thing. Okay, I switch over now to Captivate, and we will try to use such a shared action. If there is no answer, no question at this moment, everything okay? No, no question.
Yes, there's no questions at the time.
So I have here a test document. I will get some shared access into that document from the presentation you just did see. I do that by importing as an external library that presentation. One tip, the presentation has to be closed. So it's closed because you are just watching the published presentation. It will open like normally here on the top left, like a floating panel. And you see I have a lot of shared access in that presentation. Now I have to drag them, and that's a small problem, Andrew. I can't see my right docking panel. I have to move a little bit.
Yeah, at the top of your user interface, there's a little red arrow on the left side. You should be able to click that and minimize the GoToWebinar.
I see. Thank you. So I go to my library. By the way, I'm working in the expert user interface. I have my own workspaces. So I will drag some of the shared access to this project. They don't have any access at this moment. It's completely empty. And I want to show you also that the variables dialog is also completely empty. I took out those automatic creating user variables, API, quiz info, user ID and username. So watch what will happen when I drag this shared action over to the library of this project, toggle states. It appears the normal extension if you do an export will be CPAA, those captivate advanced actions, but it's not an advanced action, it's a shared action. Okay. Did something happen in the variables dialog box at this moment? No. What that means, that is that this shared action has no variables in it that are not used as parameters. I will drag another one over, VisipAct. And when I go to the variables dialog box, you will see that one variable has been created automatically, the variable vvisip, and it has its value, it's set to zero, because it will be treated as a Boolean variable with only two possible values, zero or one, and it will track the visibility of an object. I will now drag over also the shared action that we will use for the dashboard. It's this one. And when I look again at the variables dialog box, you see that I suddenly have six variables because that shared action that needed five variables. They are called V1 until V5. Okay. Let's start now. I will keep it open but minimized. Let's start with that visible shared action. That's the one I want to trigger with this button. This button, I labeled it as shape button info. Oh, this moment has no action. It has, however, states. It has the normal three states, normal rollover and down, but I created a custom state which I labeled off, where you see that there is a cross over the button itself, but it has an added shape with information. Okay. Now I will trigger the shared action, VisipAct. I open the dialog box with the parameters. He asked, what is the multi-state button that you are using? That's the multi-state button. You can see it in the properties panel on top there, SP info. The normal state of the button is normal, and the state when an added item will be visible is off. Save. Okay, let us try. Not in the right place, but I can change that in the dialog box. But you see what the meaning is of that shared action. When I enter this dashboard, we will create, just in a minute, we will create the shared action to use for the buttons. But when I enter that dashboard, I want to use that dash_act action that will check if all buttons are clicked, and something will happen when all buttons are clicked. So for that reason, I go to the slide event on enter, execute shared action, this act. Not much to happen, you see. What has to be shown and have effects, that's what will happen when all the buttons have been clicked. You will see that in the presentation later on. I have on this dashboard an image. I forgot the name, but I think E-end. Yeah, the image, and you can also use an audio because you will not be able to hear it, I think, but I will add some audio. So this is the shared action that will check if all the buttons have been clicked and then show something at the end. Okay. now you have seen a little bit how to use a shared action. And before we will start to create a shared action, oh no, I wanted to show the TOC toggle button as well. So now I have another toggle states button. And this button has four parameters. One of the parameters is the variable that controls the visibility of the table of content in overlay. And that's cp command toc visible. Which button is triggering it? It's the button, I think, with toc in it. Yes. Normal, it looks like this. So I can put on the table of content. And when it's set on, it will show another state. Here, that's the state of the table of content button when it's showing so that you can turn it off. We'll check another time. We can't check the functionality of the dashboard itself yet because we don't have actions for the dashboard buttons yet. I will switch back a little bit to my presentation. So the first item has been viewed. This is a visited state for those users who don't have one not yet on Captivate 2017, you don't have the visited state as an inbuilt state. So you need to make it a little bit more complicated. You need a custom state for that. Let us now see to the workflow of creating a shared action. And there I try to give you some tips. If the action is really not complicated, that would be my workflow. Start by creating the action without giving it a name in the advanced action dialog box. That's step one. And think already what will be the parameters. For some, you don't have the choice. For others, you have a choice. The second step is to save as a shared action. Fill in, give it a good name, of course. So the name is being given here. Not in the advanced actions dialog box, and give it a good description. Tell what you will be doing. It's so much easier when you open that shared action months later to see exactly what you have programmed in it. So that's the first step to fill in this box. Then you will see in that box, in the first column, two types of checks. There is the yellow triangle with an exclamation mark. And that means that this detected parameter has always to be a parameter. I call it a compulsory parameter. When will it be accepted as a parameter? When you fill in the description of that parameter. So in this case, it's the shared action we will be making for the dashboard buttons. And what has that shared action to do? It has to go to the first slide of a chapter. So that's that compulsory parameter, the first slide of that chapter. And then there are two other possible parameters. The possible parameters are variables and literals. So what I'm doing with this button action, as well as going to the first slide of a chapter, is to toggle the tracking variable for that chapter, in this case, V1 to 1. When I go to use this shared action for the second chapter, I will have to change V1 to V2. But I don't have to change one, because I will then change the tracking variable, the second tracking variable, to 1 because it has a default value of 0. So that means that one of the two has to be a parameter, but not both of them. In this case, the variable has to be a parameter. I indicate it to be a parameter, and then it becomes just like the slide there, which was a compulsory parameter. You have to enter a description before the sign, the yellow sign, will turn into a green check mark. It's not necessary in this case to change or to make the literal into a parameter. And then the most important part is to test in all situations, of course. It's only then that you'll be sure that you didn't have any bugs in your shared action. We'll try to do that in Captivate. So we will make a shared action for the buttons on the dashboard. And that shared action starts in the Advanced Actions dialog box. No name needed. It's not a conditional action. So I start with the first line. I have to toggle the value of the tracking variable of one of the chapters. So I choose a sign. And it's the first variable that it's an example. You can also choose the second, it doesn't make out. It's not a variable value, it's always 1. And then I have to jump to a slide. Discord, I think the first is visibility. Okay. Now I will save this as a shared action. I will give it a name. Description will jump to first slide and toggle the tracking variable. So the compulsory parameter is in this case the slide to jump to. The literal doesn't have to be a parameter, but the variable has to be a parameter, and the parameter here means the tracking variable. It's like in an Excel table, you have to confirm by enter before it's accepted. And I save that shared action. Once it's saved, I can trigger it by the buttons like I want. So I first button toggle visibility. It has also 4 states, and the 4th state is the visited state. So that's new in Captivate 2017. The action to be triggered is a shared action. I called it dash button. It is the first chapter, so I can use V1. That is the most logical. You are totally free. You can choose something else. And it has to jump to visibility. Save. I do the same for this one. It will use another parameter. And I have to go to hide show. And the last one. Goes to the last slide. Okay. So now I have a bit of a trouble a problem. Because when you look at the onEnter action, the shared action was made from a presentation which had 5 buttons. When you go to the advanced action dialog box and you open this list, that's the list with the templates. I try to explain later on more about it. When you look at that DAS act, in the first part of the condition, you see that I require V1 is equal to 1, V2 is equal to 1, V3, V4, but I will never have 5 in this case because I have only 4 buttons. Now, one of the drawbacks of shared actions is that you can't edit them. I have 2 possible solutions. Let's start with the easiest one in this case before we have later on. I will change the action and turn it into an advanced action. That is, set the last variable 5 to 1. Then it's always already okay. It's never used really, not with the button action, but it will not mess up the condition. So I will do that as a first solution. I go to the variables dialog box. I go to 5. And instead of 0, I set it to 1. And now the condition is really limiting to 4 variables. Okay. I think, yeah, it's about half an hour. I first want to see if there are some questions.
Yes, there are 2 questions that have come in. One is, if you have created a page with advanced actions outside of your current project, can you also import those actions as well as the objects from the outside project?
The objects never. You are talking about advanced actions or shared actions?
These are advanced actions.
No, advanced actions can't be imported or exported on itself. You can copy and paste objects that have advanced actions attached to it to another project. But you have to be sure in that other project that everything is pointing the right way. So if you have an advanced action that is pointing to a slide that doesn't exist in that new project, or to an object that doesn't exist in that new project, what will happen? That is that you will get, now that's new from Captivate 9, you will get a drop-down list the same way as you see when you open one of the shared actions as a template. So you will get this. Items that are not recognized will now show up like this if you copy an advanced action. That's already a lot better than before, because before, each command in an advanced action that you copied with an object, because you can't copy it on itself, that you transfer to another project triggered by an object would show up as continue. So the command would be lost. Now it will not be lost, but you know, I almost never copy or try to transfer advanced actions to other projects anymore. It's a lot more work than turning the advanced action into a shared action. Is that sufficient?
Yes, it looks like that answers the question. The other question here is, how does Captivate decide which ones are compulsory and which ones aren't?
That will appear in my presentation. Okay.
Okay, great.
Yeah, good. Come on. Another question?
Let's see. I'm seeing one more question here. I have Captivate 2017 and imported advanced actions still show up as continue in a new project.
Was that advanced action was created in which version?
Alice will need to know what version in Captivate 2017 is what she says.
Was it perhaps an advanced action triggered by a slide event? I was talking only about advanced actions triggered by interactive objects.
She says no.
Not by a slight event. Normally, it's better now than ever, but I should say, don't try to do it. You could make your project very corrupted. Another tip, never use a template file, so a CPTL that has advanced access in it, because you will end up throwing your computer away.
Okay, that answers the question then. No more questions at this point.
Yeah, okay. Andrew, could you put up the other polls after this first part?
Sure. So the poll showing now is about multi-state objects in Captivate 9 in 2017. Do you use these regularly? So those responses are coming in now. This is a multiple select question, so you can select more than one if more than one apply to you. So do feel free to click on as many boxes as you need. But those responses are coming in. Early results show about 45% of our audience uses them already in combination with advanced actions. I'll go ahead and give you guys about 5 more seconds to poll here. All right, so the results of that first poll are 45% are already using them, 28% only use states for interactive objects, 26% use them but not in combination with advanced actions. And then we have the remaining prefer hide or show or discover new uses for multi-state objects. The other poll that we will put up right now is, do you understand the difference between advanced actions and shared actions? We'll give you guys a few moments to poll there. About 5 more seconds. Last chance if you'd like to poll.
Well, please, all those who are online in 2017, and that's a majority here, get to grips with multi-state objects, because if you ever want to use fluid boxes, they are the only way to go, because you can't have objects stacked on each other anymore in fluid boxes. So the solution is to use multi-state objects.
All right, the results of the advanced actions and shared actions. 38% of our audience does understand the difference. 39% of our audience partially understands, and 23% of our audience does not understand the difference between shared and advanced actions.
Those who are partially understanding, I hope it will go better when I continue. And those who don't like to use them, maybe I'm not a good teacher. Okay. So I will switch to the drag and drop example, because I think that's a good example as well. And we create another shared action before I return to my presentation. So what's the setup here? I have a drag and drop, which has 3 correct answers and 3 wrong answers. So the goal is to drag them into this container. You know all about drag and drop. You know that drag and drop slides have object actions. So what I want to do here, if you look at my timeline, you will see there's something hidden here. I call it the comments shape, and that comment shape has some states. This is the normal state. I want this state to appear when a correct answer is dragged into the container. When the answer is not correct, I want one of the other states to appear. So I have an individual feedback for each of the wrong answers. Okay? Now, the problem is I don't want those appeared states of that shape remain eternally on the slide. I want them to disappear after a certain amount of time. So we will set that up. And since I have only one state for all correct answers, in this case, I would prefer to use an advanced action for the correct answers. Whereas for the wrong answers, I have individual states for each wrong answer. In that case, I will use a shared action. So I hope this will make the difference more clear between advanced and shared actions. So let's go back to the advanced actions dialog box. What do I want to do for a correct answer? I want the comments to show up. I could also apply an effect and all that, but I will leave it like this. I don't have to specify it has to show up as normal, but I could do it. So to be sure, because I didn't activate retain state on slide revisit, but you never know, I remain on the same slide. So I will go to change state of comments to normal. So then success will appear. This will be an advanced action. So that means I have to give it a name, correct act. But I want also to have it disappear after a certain amount of time, let us say 2 seconds. So I choose delay. Next actions by 2 seconds. And then I want to hide the comments again. I think this is clear enough. I will save this as an action. Now I will create a shared action. And the shared action is pretty similar to this one, except for the state. So I want perhaps for the wrong answer, curved motion parts are new. I want to change it to curve. I could make the literal because some of the comments are longer. Success is very short, but some of the comments are longer. So I can make this into a parameter. This has to be a parameter. So state is something that's always a parameter. Okay. And now I will save this as a shared action. I will not label it correct act. It will be the wrong act. Will show a comment for wrong answer in drag and drop in this. And comment is a multi-state object. So this is the multi-state object. That is the state to show. And I want this to be variable, so this is the delay in seconds. Oh. So now I go to my drag and drop panel. I select the drop target, go into the object actions dialog box, and you see that target is accepting all objects. Multi is a wrong answer, so I need a shared action. Today wrong act is okay. The multi-state object is always comments. It's a pity. You have to log a feature request so that you can choose which are compulsory and which not at this moment. Only literals and variables are free. Stay to show which one I'm on. Multi-state and delay in seconds. Let us say 3 seconds. Typekit is a new feature, so that's okay. Fluid boxes is a new feature, so I use the fast action. Curved motion paths are not new, so I need the shared action. Comments delete in second. Visited state is new, so I need the advanced action. Our shape state is wrong. Let's try it. I will first pull the wrong ones. Multi-state object. So I get a comment and it will disappear after the delay I told. Visited states for buttons are new, so success. Shape states on master slides are not new, they existed in CP8, they were lost in CP9. Curved motion part was new in CP9. Typekit integration is correct. Fluid boxes is correct. Does that help for those who were still confused between shared and advanced actions? So why did I use the advanced action for the success comment? Because it's always the same action. There are no parameters needed. It's always the same. Whereas that was not the case. If I had to do this with advanced actions for the wrong answers, I would have to duplicate the same advanced action 3 times and edit them 3 times. It takes up more space in the file. I have some proofs of that. So it's better to use instances. It's the same with images. Use the same image over and over again. It will not increase the file size, but if you take always different images, of course, that will increase the file size. Okay. I get back to my presentation. So that was my workflow. I explained for an uncomplicated action. Very quickly, we will, I think, not have time for a complicated action, because there I would recommend first to create it as an advanced action. You see here one example. I think it's somewhere in one of my blogs of a pretty complicated action for automatically appearing lists. Once you have created it for one instance, you test it as much as possible, and only when you are sure about the workflow of that advanced action will you convert it into a shared action. You see, it's also pretty complicated as shared actions, because you have to think about which of the things will be parameters, and I will come to what's the difference between compulsory and candidate parameters in a moment. So the parameter types, that was one of the questions. I have a drag and drop, of course, with 2 baskets from the home country of my late husband, Burundi. What happens when I drag something in it? What are the compulsory parameters? Those are the parameters that are always defined as parameters at this moment. Well, everything that's static is anyway a parameter. So slides are often used in navigation. Audio clips are static as well. States, you have seen them a couple of times in the actions we created. Images is one of those static objects. So, but also buttons, if you have them, are compulsory. Literals, you have seen one can be a parameter, but don't have to be a parameter. My delay is a little bit too short, it seems. Yeah. And variables can be parameters, but they don't have to be parameters. And one interesting feature is that when you have a parameter in a shared action, and you created that parameter as being a parameter, that was an image, you can replace that image by a group. You can replace it by a web object. You can replace it by a video, by an animation. So some parameters are always the same. A state is a state. Of course, you can't replace it by something else. A variable is a variable. You can't replace it. But the other objects can be replaced. I use groups quite a lot. I will stop a moment. Andrew, do you have any questions?
There is a question here. Is there a way of applying a shared action to multiple drag and drop objects at once rather than adding them individually?
No. But you can't do it with advanced actions neither. It's not to the objects that I triggered them. I applied them to the object actions. And it's the same if you use a simple action, even if it's the same simple action, or you use an advanced action or a shared action, they have to be done one by one.
All right, there's no other questions at this time, but we did have several people that wanted to let you know that you're a great teacher.
Because I told, but did they understand? No, I want to see, maybe we can do it at the end, the poll again about, and do you understand the difference between shared actions and advanced actions? Maybe sure. It was too early.
Sure.
Okay. So using a shared action as a template, I see I have 10 minutes left. It's very, okay. You did see already the drop-down list on top. Maybe you never did see it, but once you have a shared action, it's not limited only to blank. That's what appears there when you don't have any shared action. When you have a shared action, it will appear over there and you can open it. I showed it in Captivate as well. Now you can use it to create things. You can use it to create an advanced action. We can do that with the on-enter action of the dashboard. Instead of tweaking, cheating, I should say, on Captivate and say, oh, I don't use V5, so I will say that V5 is always equal to 1. I find that cheating. It's not, I have been teaching a lot, so I know what cheating is. A second possibility is to create an edited shared action. Something I don't have much time for it, but if you want to know about it, you can have a look at one of my blog posts. Contrary to advanced actions, you can reuse the name of a shared action. You can't do that with advanced actions, you know that. So what you can do is you take out the shared action from everywhere where it's triggered. You then open it in the advanced actions dialog box and you create an advanced actions from it and you edit it. You delete the first shared action and then you can create a shared action with the same name again. So that's the second possibility. The third possibility, I wished I have time to show it totally, I'm not sure. That is to combine such a shared action, turn it into advanced action, it can be one decision, and then you combine it with another decision. Okay. So I first finish my presentation. And then I see if I have 5 minutes left, I will be able to create another shared action. When don't I use shared actions? Well, once I have more than 5 parameters, I'm thinking about, wouldn't it be better to create duplicate advanced actions than to have always to define all those parameters? That can become annoying. If it's a very complicated and very specific action, it has no sense to turn it into a shared action, of course. Something that can be frustrating, and I logged a feature request and I got some promise that it will change. If you have the same variable like v1 used in several actions, and you drag those shared actions all to a new project, and there will be, example, you have v1 used in 2 shared actions in a project, you drag both of them over to a new project, and you will end up with 2 variables, v1 and v11. So that's very annoying. I have a workaround for it, but I hope they will listen and improve some parts of that, so that you have more control over which parameter is compulsory and which parameter is candidate. You have to be careful with literals. Making bad choices could end up in frustrations. You know, if you use the same number one for many parameters, I try to make, if I have multiple literals as parameters, I will try to give them in the example I'm making to create action, to give them different numbers. I hope you understand what I mean. If you don't have parameters, you can ask, why should I create a shared action? Yes, it's a little bit related with one of the questions before. It's so much easier to transfer a shared action to another project than an advanced action. And the second advantage is you see them in the library, and so you can see if they have been attributed enough, if the usage dialog box is correct. It's so much easier to use than to have to scroll in the advanced actions dialog box. Okay, so do we have 5 minutes left? I don't have a poll for that.
we do have 5 minutes left.
Yeah, 5 minutes left. Can I have 5 minutes? So now is the choice. I have something here, but only 5% are not on CP9 or later. This is a show height thing with a group here instead of multi-state objects. That's an alternative. I will not do that. This is the most interesting, but I hope I can do it in 5 minutes. So we have the dashboard. The dashboard has a conditional action. When all the buttons have clicked, then you did see the finish me there in the presentation. Something similar is often asked on the forums. How can I force a learner, I hate that word, or can I force a learner to do all those things before they can move? So in this case, that back button is hidden. Yeah. And it should appear only when I have clicked the 5 buttons. That's forcing. Okay. But that's a little bit similar to what I do with that dashboard. I need 5 tracking variables, which I have already, V1 until V5. But I don't have 2 actions. On the dashboard, I had an onEnter action that is checking the variables, and I had action for the buttons themselves that were jumping to chapter slides. So I don't have that. That means I have to combine the check decision with a decision where I toggle a variable. Okay. I can do that from that original shared action that I used on the dashboard. This one. So the condition is okay. I have 5 variables. But I don't want all those things here done. I just want to show the next button when all the conditions are fulfilled. So I will delete those 4. and I want to show, and I think, SB Backforce. Okay, this is a decision that will check. Now I need to first have a decision to toggle a variable, the variable for that chapter. So I will put that here. Those who read my blog sometimes know that I often use the word always. That was more important in previous version than in the new advanced access dialog box, of course. And what I have to do, I have to assign a variable with one. Yes, but this has to happen before the check. So I love those icons here. So I have to move always to the left. And I will define this as a shared action. No. Why wouldn't I do that? If I define it as a shared action, I have the problem that V1 is used here. V1 is used here. I would have to define all the variables as parameters. There will be an active variable and the others. And that means that in that shared action, I would have to define 6 parameters. I told you already that 5, mostly for me, is the limit. So I will not do this. I will create an advanced action in that case. So the one act. I save this as action. I will duplicate it. I call this the two act. And the only thing that has to be changed, you see why I use now advanced actions? Because it's less work. I save that. I duplicate it again. And that will be the 3 act. And the variable has to be 3. I duplicate again for act 4. And one last time. That's it. I hope you believe me. I don't know. Can I show it or not? I just have to attribute the actions. So one act. Two act. I forgot something. I have to put the variables back to 0 normally on the beginning. Because I have been reusing the variables that were already used on the first slide. But when I play only this slide, it will be okay. No, I have changed V5 to 1. I'm a multitasker, you can hear it. Okay, so I have to change back the variable V5 to 0. Oh, it will not work. And last demo. There it is. Okay. Thanks. Just in time? Yeah, just in time. Okay. Andrew, more questions?
Perfect. I'm looking through these questions. People are wanting to know about your blog and where they can find you there. I will put that information up on the screen really quickly. We want you guys to be able to continue the conversation as you wish. So here on the screen, you can see how to reach out to Leva, the consultant trainer, ACEACPAEL. You can reach out to her by email, info@lilybiddy.com. Follow her blog. There's the blog link. You can also find her on the Captivate forums.
Andrew, you have a PDF for the attendees.
Yes.
And everything is on it as well. There's also a link to the Adobe forums. There's a link to the Temple of Legends, and there's a link to the e-learning portal as well. I'm always there, except when I'm sleeping.
Okay, so yeah, look for that. We'll send you an email, and it'll have all of that information perfectly for you. It'll be there's a PDF, just like she mentioned, that you can get, and you'll find her in various social media locations. But thank you so much, Leva. This has been wonderful. This has been great. We're getting lots of positive feedback. You've changed people's lives today.
So. Oh my God! No. Even Hawking did.
It's true. He did. Thank you very much, everyone, for joining us, and we'll hopefully see you in future webinars and online. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.